Hello and welcome back to another CFD analysis tutorial in Grasshopper Rhino. And as I mentioned a few weeks ago, I wanted to look into an alternative to the Ladybug Tools Butterfly CFD tool, which is called Eddy 3D. And it was recommended to me by Ramya Kanan. I hope I pronounced it correctly. If not, please apologize. But thank you. It's great and it's very reassuring that my videos are not completely for nothing and people watch it and they engage with it and engage with me, which is exactly what I wanted to get out of this YouTube channel. So what is Eddy 3D? Eddy 3D is an alternative tool to the Butterfly CFD, which is also an app for Grasshopper, but they use the same core engine, the OpenFOAM CFD engine, Blue CFD. So the Blue CFD core project is basically bringing the OpenFOAM CFD engine to Windows so we can use it for our CFD calculations in Grasshopper Rhino. So what is the difference between Ladybug Butterfly and or Butterfly CFD and Eddy 3D? So Eddy 3D I had a first view, but it seems it's more focused on wind analysis, outdoor comfort, landscape planning, urban planning, landscape design. So situations for outdoor city planning, situations for outdoor wind analysis and the outdoor comfort. What is special, I think, and I haven't seen that in any other CFD analysis tool, that you can actually place trees, and I imagine they have a certain factor of letting wind through an object. So basically have a tree is not blocking wind completely, it's mitigating prevailing winds and diffuses its direction and its strength. So that is very interesting. I think there is, you can specify, I think in Rhino CFD you can actually specify areas, like a bigger volume of, let's say, an area where there's like a lot of tree crowns, but that is not a grasshopper. So long story short, we want to look into Eddy 3D now and see what we need to care about, what we need to install first, and so on, and how to actually get it running, and then how to start with it. Because what is great with that software is that you have already pre-like templates which you can just place into your whatever, blah blah blah, let's start. So in order to download, we just go to Eddy 3D. The creators, the people responsible, they named the software after Eddy, which is a term in fluid dynamics, a term coming from the fluid dynamics, which is the swirling of a fluid and the reverse current created when the fluid is in a turbulent flow regime. Obviously looks like this. So that's where the name comes from. And if we want to download, we go to www.eddy3d.com, and then you can hear, when you scroll down, you can actually get it has this download button, Eddy airflow and microclimate simulations for Rhino and Grasshopper. Download Eddy, and then you you need to leave your name and address and why you want to have it, and also what are the latest versions, what are the latest. It says here it works in Rhino 6, but I tried it actually, and it seems it works fine. Also, it works also in Rhino 7. And then it also has a support page, a documentation, and here, very important, you need to install Eddy, and it's described in your download, so you can download it then. Just follow the instructions. You also need to install Blue CFD, which in this folder, in the default folder. So you shouldn't change that because the script will actually look for the Blue CFD installation in this folder. That's important. And I don't know where, but it seems like there are components which also use Radiance, and we just installed Radiance in the previous video, so you can check that out. But it's very straightforward because it's just go to the site, download one of the installers, which are on GitHub. So you go to the latest version, and you can download it here for Windows. You can see here after you download CFD. I think it's after you downloaded the blue CFD and you installed it, then I think what you need to do, and that you need to do for Ladybug, for Butterfly CFD, you need to actually create a environment. So you need to double click this. Oh, sorry. You need to. I would do right click and run as administrator, and it will create this window here, and it will set up an environment, and you only need to do that once. And it seems here environment is now ready. That's what is written here. So then you can actually close that. So I'm pretty sure this need to be done before you start running your before you start running Rhino and Eddy 3D. What else you need to be careful? Okay, we also need to start Rhino 7 as administrator. That I would recommend, because whenever an app in Grasshopper needs to start other software outside Rhino, it need to run in the administrator mode. Okay, I go just here on meter. Although it says it's not updated yet for Rhino 7, we can still try and see what we can get out of it. Yeah, that all worked. Again, so you install Eddy 3D first, then you install blue CFD. The links are all on the website. And then you run Grasshopper. Then you create an environment with the CFD terminal. And then you start Rhino 6, in that case 7, in administrator mode. These are the four steps which are important, otherwise it will not run. Okay, and then you should actually see it here. It should all work. I did a video, by the way, on how to install blue CFD, so you might want to check it out on the top of the screen. And yeah, if you compare now, for example, Butterfly has this kind of user or this like interface kind of symbols which are not very intuitive, I have to say. I would make these more intuitive if I would be the developers for Butterfly, to be honest. And compared to Eddy 3D, it's more nice to look at. What is really cool is that it has template. It has an object here called templates. If you put that here, you have an option to have an alternative direction, I guess, where you can store different scripts, and it will bring the scripts directly in. But here it has a button on the lower end. I don't know why it needs this output here, but yeah. On the lower end, it shows you what's in that folder. So there's a default folder with pre-made templates, script templates, which is, yeah, it's pretty cool. So right click, and then you can actually choose these. And we would start with visualize wind vectors. No, let's start with the simple wind analysis. We just will look into that today. That's it. And yeah, it's right out of the box, a workable script. It already includes, it actually loaded my previous calculation, and it has some stored geometry in here, just so you can test without building anything. That's quite amazing, even with some terrain model. So actually here, so you can see if you click here, it's the geometry boundary conditions. So you have this cluster of buildings or objects, and then you have the terrain as a geometry in here, and you can exchange this. You can kick this out, of course. You can clear the value, and then this is gone. And then you can have different values for your wind direction. So I guess if I changed it, what happens? Basically rotates your bounding condition, your boundary. So the test will happen inside this box, and it rotates the whole box. Okay, let's keep it as zero. Let's keep it as it is, and let's leave the other things for now. I'll just turn off the preview here. Yeah, it's pretty cool organized. So here it creates the simulation domain that brings everything together. It creates the domain here. So it creates the domain with everything what is inside. And here you have the option with trees. And then you have your creating your mesh, as you can remember from Ladybug Butterfly, that you have to create the mesh and the snappy hex mesh. That's done all in here. You have different settings. We will maybe look at that at some point. I will just leave it as it is for now. And you can also look at the residuals during the simulation. So if I run that now, okay. So what are residuals, you might ask? Of course, I also asked this myself. So residuals is basically a way to measure on how correct your solution is. It's a, I think this is the most simplest way to describe it. Here's a more better description at engineering.com. And it says here, the residual is one of the most fundamental measures of an iterative solution's convergence, as it directly quantifies the error in the solution of the system of equations. In CFD analysis, the residual measures the local imbalance of a conserved variable in each control volume. Therefore, every cell in your model will have its own residual value for each of the equations being solved. In an iterative numerical solution, the residual will never be exactly zero. However, the lower the residual value is, the more numerically accurate the solution. Yeah, you can read more here, and well, let's actually run the solution first. Let's see how that, maybe let's open this. Be interesting if there's anything happening during the mesh simulation. And here you can see we discussed that before. In butterfly was the different fields you can actually test. U was the vectors, and P for example was the Pascal, the pressure, I think. So we can discuss a bit more about residuals, but in this video we just look into how this, like how Eddy sets up the script, and exploring what's possible here. It's really cool that they already set up this like template, so we don't need to work it out. Although I think it's still, we still need to go through all the different components to actually understand it better. It also need to probe the probing points and probing, and I will clean this here, I think. Yeah, so with that there's a button where you can actually clean the solution or the output, and then rerun it again. Now this became orange, so we need to, so this area is basically our probe points. So we created, they create here a mesh plane, and I mean that's very similar to what we did before in butterfly CFD. So we created a plane, and then we created a grid of points, which are the probe points. And now so the solution runs, and then it asks to visualize the probe points. Let's do that. So it runs 1,000 iterations. I'm wondering if we can actually adjust it. Now it finished, okay. And then you can see how the calculation stabilizes towards the 1,000. The residuals. Okay, so now let's try this again. So we ran the whole thing, we ran the simulation, and you can see here there's this landform here. I'll try to bake that so it's... And we can also turn off the probe points. Don't need to see that. So it becomes better to read. Let's see if we can also look at it in rendered view. And we can also, of course, bake these if we want. Yeah, I mean, it's very straightforward. It's very straightforward. Everything is set up. This is really great. Yeah, so we can here in post-processing, we can look at the output within ParaView, which comes with the blue CFD installation. So if I click here, you actually go to this software here, which gives you a more different ways to actually look at your output. That's, you can do the same in Ladybug, but I haven't figured out how to actually get this model in here. And here's in Eddy's basically automatically. And you can see here the domain and the wind speed in the different colors. The chart here, that's quite cool. And you can then look at the output in different ways, for example, vectors here. But we will look into that a bit more in detail for sure, because I want to get a bit of training first. So there are different ways to look at it. It's pretty cool. And you can also slice through here. So you can, with this one, you can basically choose a location for your slice and then apply. You can see this in a section. But yeah, you can actually move back and forward here and then test the different areas. Because what we see here is actually only the probe points to make the probe points visible. But the calculation did actually, the solution ran through the whole domain, through all the different cells of your domain. And this is not visible here. So you can actually look at it a bit more in detail in ParaView. I will go for sure a bit more and one of the next videos where we explore a bit more, because there's quite a lot to look at. We will also explore a bit more what we can do with ParaView. Amazing stuff. Yeah, if the wind vectors, as we did before, setting the different limits, if we can automate that the same as we did in Butterfly, because at the moment it doesn't show us really the values. Let's see here. Okay. Oh, this is a cluster. We could also at some point look into that, what that does. I guess it calculates the minimum and maximums. We can also look into that, what's happening here, so we know a bit better. Here, the width. Ah, I didn't really know that. So you can actually change the width of your vectors. And then here, yeah, it has a button to clean everything. Then run this again. Very promising. Okay, I'm looking forward to test a bit more with it. Yeah, I just realized my video went off. That's pretty promising. Looking forward to explore more in one of the next videos. See you, have a good time.